Minnesota in the national spotlight, doubling down to keep abortions legal here. And our state, as you can see by this map, surrounded by others that already have or will put abortion ban in place. And joining us for more context this morning is Lieutenant Governor Peggy Flanigan. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
As we just saw that map, as we said, you know, we're surrounded by states that are likely banning or already banned abortions. And Planned Parenthood here says 25%, they're going to see a 25% influx in patients from these states. So how is Minnesota preparing for all of this?
So in Minnesota, it's important to note that we still have access to abortion. In Minnesota, the governor has just signed an executive order into law protecting Minnesotans who are seeking abortion care or those who would come from outside Minnesota to seek abortion care, as well as the providers who do those procedures as well.
So on the other side of things, there's a large group of people celebrating the Supreme Court's decision. They believe it protects basic human rights. What do you say to them?
I would say that as a mom of a 9-year-old little girl, she will have fewer rights than her mother does, and even, you know, than her grandmother did. Even in the case of rape and incest, our opponent, Scott Jensen, said that he would force a woman to carry her pregnancy to term. So to be really candid, I don't see anything worth celebrating there. And this is the first time that, you know, in my lifetime that we have lost a constitutional right. I think people are nervous. I think they're afraid. And we're going to try to do everything that we can to protect access to abortion in Minnesota.
And speaking of your Republican opponent, you know, come midterm elections just 5 months away, abortion is going to be a big hot topic issue. So how are you and Governor Walz keeping Minnesota or planning to keep Minnesota a safe haven for people, you know, coming to our state and Minnesotans?
Sure. So, you know, I think sometimes people ask, you know, or assume, oh, Minnesota's will be just fine. We're one election away from losing access to abortion. So Governor Walz and I are deeply committed to making sure the Minnesotans have access. We'll do everything that we can. But really, we know that this will be a focus of the election. We're ready, we're prepared, and we know that Minnesotans, the overwhelming majority of Minnesotans, share our perspective that abortion should be accessible and safe in the state.
When you look at this ruling, do you think this opens up the Supreme Court to look at other past rulings and reconsider them as well?
I mean, I think, you know, Justice Clarence Thomas sent that signal that the rights of our LGBTQ plus Minnesotans, the right to be able to marry the person that you love, access to contraceptives. This all feels like things that I think the country is comfortable with, has been decided, and to take us backwards is frightening, but we are here. And if Minnesota needs to be an island where people can have access to abortion, can love who they love and marry who they love, protect access to health care, we're going to be that state.
All right, Lieutenant Governor Peggy Flanigan, thank you so much for taking some time out of your day with us this morning.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, on the Republican side, gubernatorial challenger Scott Jensen is vowing for an all-out ban on abortion, regardless of rape or incest. He said in part, it's time for a compassionate discussion on availability of low-cost or free birth control and elevating adoption in a society where there are thousands of parents wanting to have children and have a family.
Let's turn our attention right